I was involved in Paranipolis in Prague for several years. And back maybe a few years ago, I think 2018, not sure exactly when, but we had a group of people in the basement of Paranipolis in the hackerspace there in the basement. And we were doing meetups regularly where we tried to learn new stuff, learn new specific technologies, learn about like cryptographic primitives or how to build mobile apps, how to do I don't know, decentralized. We tried stuff with IPFS. We tried many different things, different technologies we were interested in. So we would try a different project, and eventually we noticed Lightning Network a few years ago. So we started to look into it more. We read the papers. We decided that this thing made sense, that this is the way. I think actually, no, it was not 2018. It had to be around SegWit, the whole drama around the SegWit 2.0 and or SegWit 2X is what it was, right? This I don't want to rehash all the drama there. I'm very happy that Taproot did not continue this, that it was relatively drama-free and smooth, as opposed to the SegWit times. But I remember reading about Lightning Network needing the elimination of the transaction malleability in, and that's what SegWit provided. And well, it was one of the benefits. And then that's when we started to look into it a little bit. We didn't really try anything with it until we did the first iteration of a Blescomat app, let's say. It started as an app where we wanted a way for people to buy Bitcoin instantly. And the way to do that was not on-chain because you'd have to wait for confirmations, of course. So that's why we liked Lightning, was this instant nature of settlement. And it felt more like the original ideas from the Bitcoin white paper that you could transact in the real world using Bitcoin.